Safari Profiles is my favorite new feature in macOS Sonoma. If you have multiple accounts for anything, multiple Gmail accounts, YouTube channels, or you just want to be able to separate your personal and work information and logins in Safari, Safari Profiles is the way to do it. macOS Sonoma has cool features, the live wallpapers are fun, the continuity camera features are cool, but Safari Profiles has changed my entire workflow on the Mac. I'm gonna walk you through my process of using Safari Profiles that helps me manage four different accounts where I have different logins, and in each profile, I stay logged in the right account. They can each have their own set of favorites and bookmarks, and even their own set of tab groups specific to each profile. And before you leave that comment, yes, I know Google Chrome has had profiles for a long time, but Safari did it better. What can I say? And yes, my voice is a little deeper today because I have a cold, but it makes for a good radio voice. To set up new Safari profiles, I'm gonna go to the Safari app on my Mac and then go to Settings. Under the Settings, you'll see the Profiles tab here. You have a personal default profile, which you can still set an icon and a color, and then you can set up multiple profiles. Click the plus button here at the bottom, and you can create a new one. You can create a new bookmarks folder just for this profile, or use an existing folder. I'll explain my bookmarks process in a minute, but I will have created the folder first. Then once you name it, you can create the profile. Now within each profile, you have the name, icon, and color. You can also dictate what folder is used in the favorites, how new windows open for each profile, and how new tabs open. You can also customize which extensions are active for each Safari profile. So just to show you the difference, this is the personal or default window that shows up when I open Safari. It has all the bookmarks here at the top. I do a bunch of bookmark folders. And then if I open the sidebar, you'll see tab groups specifically for my personal profile. If I were to switch to my beard.fm profile, it has a different set of favorites here at the top. It automatically opens the tabs I want for this particular account. And if I go to the sidebar, you'll actually see different tab groups. Now, if I wanted to, I could change this where the favorites that appear at the top of the Safari window are the same favorite folders that I have in my personal profile. So you'll see my beard profile with all my regular favorites. Or I can choose that specific folder I created before. I find this really useful because then you can create a bespoke Safari window or profile that has just the favorites you need to get your work done for a certain account. Maybe it's your job, or maybe it's a side gig where you have a specific project management platform and a different login for that, and it keeps you logged in so you don't have to keep switching accounts, logging in, logging out. So as you think about your profiles, the first thing I would do is go to your bookmarks and then go ahead and show bookmarks, and it'll open it here in the left sidebar in Safari. You see, I have my normal favorites. These are the favorites that show up in my personal window or a non-profile window. Then I created another folder down here and a subfolder called Profiles. And then for each profile folder, I've added bookmarks to all the websites that pertain to that profile or that use case. So I'll right-click and create a new folder, and I'll just call it Work. And let's say you have particular websites you visit all the time for work. Well, now I can add bookmarks to this Work tab and then create a Safari profile that by default opens those tabs when you first activate the profile, and then those are the favorites that appear at the top of the window. For instance, if I go to File, New Window, you'll see I now have the option to open a new Safari profile window. I can go to my personal window that has all my favorites like normal, or I can go to my beard.fm profile, and you see it automatically opens the tabs that I have as my favorites. If that's how you want the behavior to be, you can go to Settings, go to the Profiles tab, go to this particular profile, and under New Windows Open With, Tabs for Bearded Teacher means it will open the tabs that I have as favorites for this profile. Again, you can choose your favorites here, and you'll see those are the folders I created. If you were creating that work profile, you can use that. Or you could just have new windows open with the start page for this profile. Now that I changed that setting, I can go to File, New Window, Beard FM Window, and now you see I'm on the start page. Again, I can change that behavior again, Settings, Profile, New Windows Open With, Tabs for Bearded Teacher, and now when I go to Window, open it, but automatically opens the tabs I want for this profile. And now this works for every profile that I have. And when it's time to do some Riverside work, I have the nice purple here with the name Riverside up in the profile. And these are all the favorites and tabs I need to do work. Or if I'm doing something with the Apple Insider podcast, I can open that profile and I have just the tabs and favorites for that work. There are some bugs here and there. Sometimes when I go to open a new profile window, it just opens every favorites that I have in my bookmarks all at once, just a ton of tabs. If that happens to you, you have to do this weird thing of go to Safari, Settings, Profiles, and under the new windows open with, just select the same choice you had and it'll fix it. It's really strange, gotta be a bug, but just do that and then the next time you open it, it'll fix it. And like I mentioned before, you can have different tab groups per profile. So here I was doing some research on my 2023 Apple tier list, and here I have all the tabs to the Apple Store that I was gonna use when I recorded the video. That tab group is specifically in my Beard FM profile. If I go to a personal window that has all my favorites, you'll see different tab groups here. Was researching bunk beds for my kids, North Carolina activities, and these are tab groups specific to just my personal Safari page. And you can actually move tab groups across profiles after they're created. If I click the three dots, I can click Move to Profile, send it to my personal Safari, and now I have my Apple tier list here. But because this is specifically about a video, I'll put it in my Beard FM profile, and now I have access to that tab group here. Also, just a little bonus tip, I have a lot of shortcuts that will process URLs, maybe to format them for show notes or even for a YouTube video, and I like making tab groups of those because then with a tab group, you can click these three dots here and you see where it says copy links. That copies all the URLs that are currently open in that Safari window, and I can paste them all very quickly. And if I ran this through a shortcut, the shortcut could process each URL with a repeat with each action. If you want to learn more about shortcuts, I do have a Shortcuts 101 with 7 easy shortcuts you could build. I walk you through each step, or just download in the video description. You can check out that video above or down in this video description. Now, one of the behaviors I had to change was I was always closing my Safari windows and just working with one. And that's okay. I do wish you could switch directly to another profile by clicking this little profile icon here. I can't open a new window, which is great, but I would love to just switch this current window to another profile. But now my workflow is typically this. I'll have a Safari window open with each profile, and I'm not usually a minimizer, but now I'll just minimize these windows, and I've changed the settings so they minimize directly into the application. And if I go down, right-click Safari, I'll see all my windows. I guess I had multiple minimized. And then I can open it up quickly and has all my tabs logged into my account, and I'm ready to go. And like I mentioned before, a huge benefit here is I have my Google account and YouTube channel logged into my Beard FM profile, and I have a different Google account logged into the Riverside YouTube channel in this window. This way I can stay logged in, I don't have to switch accounts, and it's much quicker just to open a minimized window than switch accounts for Google and then do the same thing over again going back and forth. Now I'm still on the fence of whether I like the windows minimizing into the Safari application or if I want the windows open on the dock. To change that, you can go to the Apple icon and System Settings, and then under Desktop and Dock, there's an option to Minimize Windows into Application icon. If I turn that toggle off, now minimized windows will appear down in the dock. For instance, I'll minimize this Beard FM window, and you'll see now it's down here for quick access. If I shrink that Apple Insider profile window, now you'll see they're just here quickly, and then I can maximize them or minimize them. I do think this is a little quicker. I don't know. If you have this workflow, let me know in the comments which you prefer, which you think is faster. Now, if you're a keyboard shortcut whiz, there's also the option to hide windows, but if you choose to hide Safari, it hides all your profile windows. It would be nice if there was an option to just hide specific profiles and maybe a keyboard shortcut. This way you could just quickly hide or show the profile window you want. Now, there are keyboard shortcuts to open particular profiles. Here you can see I can open a new Beard FM window with Command N, and then different keyboard shortcuts for my different profiles. That's definitely nice if you don't have the window open already. And if you memorize those keyboard shortcuts, you can quickly open a particular profile with a keystroke. But again, I've just resolved to minimize mine when I'm not using them, and I find that works really well. And like I mentioned at the beginning, you can change which extensions are active per profile. This is helpful if maybe you need to use 1Password for work, but you're using iCloud passwords for your personal stuff. Maybe you have different read it later services or other third-party extensions. And the great part is these Safari profiles actually sync to your iPad and your iPhone. So I can tap and switch to one of my profiles like my Beard FM and have the same favorites that I set up on my Mac right here on my iPad or my iPhone. And you do have those profile settings for Safari here on your iPad or iPhone as well. But go to the Settings app, scroll down to Safari, and then scroll all the way down, you'll see my different profiles here. If I tap on those profiles, I can still manage extensions and the favorites that appear at the top, but I don't have the option to open a new window or tab with my bookmarks for that particular profile. Hopefully they bring that to iPad because I really find it useful when it automatically opens those web pages first launch of the profile. So that's how I use Safari profiles on macOS and iPad. It's really changed my workflow, especially if you have multiple accounts like for work, personal, side gigs. It's a great feature and you should definitely try it out. If you want to learn more about the new features in macOS Sonoma, I have an entire video here about the top 7 features, and you can learn about 17 hidden features in iOS 17. I have that video right up here. Hit that like button and subscribe before you go, and leave a comment what's your favorite macOS Sonoma feature, or if you have any questions about Safari profiles. Thanks for tuning in. I'll catch you next time.